Hey friends, and welcome to a new video. As the title and this title screen says, I'm today showing you some tips and tricks how I fill my sketchbooks, and maybe you can apply some of those to your sketchbook. So the first thing I do is, I recommend a warm-up, and for this warm-up I'm deciding to do a contour drawing and also doing a live drawing of things I have lying around on my desk to just, get my eye-to-hand coordination in sync. And those don't have to be pretty. In fact, they are just, as mentioned, warm-ups for the day. Some random stuff, they are fun to do, and yeah. The second one is I'm playing with art supplies, meaning I just grab some random art supplies and see how they would behave together and how I can make them work together. Here I had a flat wash of acrylics that were some leftovers from the other day, and now I'm trying how gouache on acrylics works. I was pretty sure that it wouldn't, but I was curious about maybe if there are some interesting effects or if there's anything special going on when you apply gouache to acrylics. I mean, gouache is very plasticky and did I say gouache or acrylics? So acrylics are this plastic paint, and so I was curious if maybe the paint would puddle or if it would apply at all, if it would dry at all, and so I tried those. And I'm just drawing some random branches, and yeah, the paint did puddle a bit, but it did dry and it had some really interesting textures, and this was really cool to see and really interesting to work with. Next up, what I'm also doing is, these are 10 tips, but I didn't do 10 pieces. So my art tips are combinable. here are tip number 3 and 4. Draw a pet or an animal and practice something you're not familiar with, you're not good at, something you want to improve on. So I want to highly improve drawing animals, especially cats and dogs, because I own a cat and a dog, but also other animals. So I'm trying to improve on those. And yeah, so my number 3 is draw your pet. So whenever you don't know what to do, you could just either draw your pet or someone else's or just any other random animal and just have fun with it. And yeah, this is all practice, and it was fun. I really love drawing or painting my animals, my pets. it's so much fun. And also you might notice, not yet, but later you will see that I filmed this on the same day, but I'm using different pencils for almost every sketch. So whenever I do longer sketching sessions in my sketchbook, or even on a day-to-day basis, I change my pencils. So sometimes I have this clutch pencil, sometimes I have just a regular pencil you have to sharpen, sometimes I have these mechanical pencils. And if you are a bit familiar with pencils, then you know that all of them have different strong points and weaknesses, and it's always very interesting to just fool around with them and just get to know your pencils. And I don't have a personal favorite. Well, my current favorite are clutch pencils, but that might change in the future, so I'm switching them. I have a huge variety of them, so yeah. And here now I just quickly painted the sketch I did because I liked it, and I like colorful sketchbook pages, and I think the pages just look nicer and more finished when you add something to them. And the last thing I'm adding, maybe in a second, which I stole from my friend Noopsy Draws, is I added some washi tape of cats, because there was a bit of space left, and I just put this washi tape there, and I think it's super cute. So up to the next tip. There we have, use an art supply you haven't used in a while. So for me, this was, I used this ink. It's Rohre und Klinger drawing ink in violet, and it's waterproof once dry, and I'm not really good with inks. So I have a lot of inks and I used them in the past, but I'm not really good with them. And you see here I'm using a mechanical pencil, and now Tip number 6 and 7 is draw from your heart and draw maybe your favorite. I just wrote actor because I didn't know what else to write and there wasn't much space left. But your favorite actor, your favorite cartoon character, these two tips are kind of the same, but when I say draw from your heart, I mean sometimes I just don't know what I want to draw or what I want to paint or doodle or sketch, and I don't have any idea and I don't want to practice something, I just want to, you know, create. And for those who feel the same, I just say listen to what your inner voice tells you. So maybe you've just watched, I don't know, like me, just watched a movie with Keanu Reeves the other day, and then you listen to your inner voice that says, hey, I really should make a fan art, so why not? Or your inner voice tells you, hey, maybe I should just draw some random anime girl. Why not? Just listen to your heart. Draw whatever makes you happy, especially in your sketchbook. It's your sketchbook, and not every page has to be a major improvement on your style and creativity and whatnot. Sometimes you just want to draw, and that's okay. And this is what I mean with draw from your heart. But as also mentioned, if you want a challenge, then maybe, yeah, draw Keanu Reeves. I did, and you will see it in my sketchbook tour. Or draw some other popular faces, figures, or whatnot. Or maybe just random faces. Draw someone you who inspires you. Or draw maybe your version of a fictional character of a book that inspires you. That's just, it will never get old to just draw something that you really enjoy. So for me, it's still cartoon ducks, and yeah, it's just, that's just, yeah, this won't go away. And here you see me struggling with the nib. I have these nibs from Japan, and the yeah, the packaging is in Japanese, so I just grabbed one of those nibs, and it's really big and really broad, and so it was a bit of overkill on these outlines, but it was fun, and once again, it's a sketchbook, not every sketch has to be perfect, and yeah, it was fun, and I actually want to use pen nibs, is it pen nibs? Inks and nibs, I don't know, in the future, but it was also really, really hard for me to use them. So yeah, it was definitely a practice and definitely something I have to improve on. So I learned something, I guess. So this was really nice. So number 8 is take your sketchbook everywhere. And you see me here drawing outside. I was sitting on the yeah, on this tiny park part next to the library where I went, and it was a nice day, so I sat there and once again drew some cartoon ducks because that was what my yeah, inner voice told me I wanted to draw or paint. And I took my Himi or Maya Mia gouache set with me, just sat there, doodled something, had a lot of fun, and I take my sketchbook everywhere, even if I just yeah, meet a friend. So number 9 is an art journal, and here I will show you some art journal pages I did. I did this one on the train, also this one on the train, and this is not an art journal, and this one in a restaurant where I met with my best friend, and we just had fun. And number 10, last but not least, is just start at a random page and just start drawing. So yeah, these are my tips. I hope you have a nice day and speak to you again soon. Bye bye.